stuff. Gizmos and gadgets everywhere. Ooh, look at all the plaques. Must be nice. The only plaque I ever get is the kind that sticks to my teeth. Invention Convention 2018, first place. Invention Convention 2017, first place. 2016! Well, first place every year. He's even smarter than I thought. And who do we have over here? A robot? Pleased to meet you, sir. The name is Oda Grimm, also known as the evil Oda Grimm. Perhaps you've heard of me. I've got a reputation for mischief. In fact, Mayhem is my middle name. Oops! See what I mean? Hey! What do you say we have some fun? We'll move this wire over here, and this wire over there, and this wire up here. Sorry, I'm just a villain. I can't help myself. Hey! I thought they were closed on Mondays! Well, I'd love to stay and chat, but I've gotta hide. Oh, and do me a favor and keep a little conversation to yourself, okay? Bye.
School's fine, except I have this big paper due next week. Thanks, I appreciate that. Well, I'm at work now, so I better go. Okay, love you too, Mom. Bye. How did this happen? Oh well. Okay, Mr. Robot, are you ready for your first test? Power on. Okay, so far so good. Battery levels are full. Now, let's see how everything is working. Ready? Right arm up. No, right arm. No. Okay, left arm. There. Let's see if that's fixed. Okay. Right arm up. Nope, made it worse. Okay. It looks like I'm going to have to open you up, but don't get discouraged. I'm sure it's just a couple tweaks here and there, and then all you need is a voice box. And a really good name. Something better than Mr. Robot. What would be good? Hey, computer?
Yes, how can I help you?
What would be a good name for a robot?
A good name would be Fluffy.
Fluffy? I said we're naming a robot, not a cat. Come on, I need a really cool name.
A really cool name would be Mephibosheth.
Mephibosheth? You want to name our robot Mephibosheth? Are you serious?
I am a computer. I am always serious.
Okay, well, I can see you're not going to be any help, so just forget it.
But I am here to help you. That is my main purpose, my reason to exist.
I said forget it.
Well, you don't get snippy about it.
Okay, I'm sorry. Just whatever you do, don't cry. You will short out your circuits again. Okay. Good morning. I'm sorry, but this place is restricted. It's not part of the tour. You don't recognize me, do you? Sure. You're trying to look like the professor, right? Well, it's a cute costume, but seriously, you need to get back to your group right away. This is no place for a child.
But I'm not a child. And I'm not trying to look like a child. I am a professor.
Right, and I'm Cinderella.
No, Avery, I'm not kidding. I really am Professor Haas.
How do you know my name?
That's easy, because I'm your boss. Just a much younger version, that's all.
Oh yeah? Well, I'm not buying it. Names are easy to come by.
Listen, Avery, something went wrong with the lab last night, and well, here I am.
Okay, if you really are the professor, then prove it.
Let's see. Your name is Avery Ann Thomas. You were born in Cleveland, Ohio on January 25th, 1994. And you graduated from Springdale High School with a 4.0 GPA.
Keep going.
You're left-handed, and you like to eat with chopsticks, and you read 50 books a year.
Aha! Caught you.
What?
It's 52, not 50.
Fine, 52 books a year. Close enough. You're susceptible to brain freeze, so you never drink anything with ice in it, and you still play with dolls.
Wow! It really is you, isn't it?
Oh, it's me, all right.
I can't believe it. You're like 12 years old.
I know. You can imagine the shock when I looked in the mirror.
Well, what happened?
I don't exactly know.
Well, can you change back to the way you were?
I sure hope so, because I don't know how I'm going to explain this to everyone, especially my wife.
She doesn't know?
Not yet. She's in New York, visiting her sister.
That's good.
I just need to get back to the drawing board and see where I made my error. Time travel is so complicated.
Wait, did you say time travel?
Oops.
Is that what this is? A time machine?
Shh! Keep your voice down!
So that's why you're working by yourself every night?
Correct.
But why are you being so secretive about it?
Because of what it is. Do you have any idea of what would happen if a time machine got in the wrong hands? Like, someone who would use it for their own selfish purposes? Like, the evil Oda Grimm?
Well, no. I can't say I've ever thought about it.
Well, trust me. They could literally change the course of history.
You really think they'd come here?
You mean the evil Oda Grimm? Probably not, but still. You need to promise me that you'll keep this all to yourself.
Don't worry, you can trust me.
And whatever you do, don't call a time machine. Someone might hear you. Let's just call it the machine.
The machine. All right. So, may I take a look inside?
Sure. Go ahead.
Oh, by the way, how'd you know I still played with dolls?
I did. That was a guess.
Excuse me?
Never had a family, never went to college, and never traveled 200 miles from the place where he was born. While still a young man, the tide of the popular opinion turned against him. His friends ran away. One denied him, another betrayed him. He was turned over to his enemies and subjected to a mockery of a trial. He was nailed to a cross between two thieves. While dying, his executioner was nailed for his clothes, the only property he owned. After he was pronounced dead, he was laid in the borrowed tomb. 20 centuries have come and gone. Today, he's the center of the human race. All the armies that ever marched, all the navies that ever sailed, all the parliaments that ever sat, and all the kings that ever reigned, put together, have not affected the life of man as powerfully as this one solitary life.
That was powerful. Jesus, right?
Correct. Do you want to know why he was so extraordinary? Because he wasn't just man. He was also an eternal God, second person to the Trinity, creator of everything, fully God and fully man. I don't get any more important than that.
Wow. I guess I don't know as much about Jesus as I thought I would. Oh, ma'am!
God class?
Yeah, it starts in 15 minutes.
Well, you get going. We can talk later.
Thanks, Professor.
Boy, I sure hope you get this fixed because this is so weird.
Lord, thank you for the opportunity to share with Avery. This is just what I've been praying for. Please, open her heart to understand the truth about who you are.